Welcome to new Selfish OS podcast, and this time around it's another camera comparison, a very special camera comparison between the Xperia 10 Plus against the Xperia 10 Plus. Huh? So I'm comparing the Selfish OS version with the Android version. In the past with Sony Xperia devices we had always the issue on the Selfish devices that unlocking the bootloader removed all the blobs, the binary blobs for the camera, which caused, yeah, basically a very, very worsened image or worse image quality when taking camera shots. And this is now gone with the newer devices, the Xperia 10 Plus. And still, I want to compare those two devices and we'll see if the Android version or the Selfish OS version will come on top when it comes to image quality, and if there's any difference, if we can see this difference. Because then it comes to camera quality software wise and not so much driver wise, where the manufacturer has its fingers inside. It's more like you can improve it if you use the right software on your devices. So that's a nice improvement from Sony. I think all the new devices, I think with shipping Android 9, will have this feature where they don't remove the camera blobs, and so you can hope for better camera quality with third-party operating systems just like Selfish OS. And we will take a look now how the camera quality differs between those two devices. Those are basically the same devices, Xperia 10 Plus devices, one with 6 GB of RAM and one with 4 GB of RAM, so the European version and the Asian version, and we will check both of those. They have the same megapixel count, the same sensors inside. The only difference here is really the model number and the gigabytes of memory. That's basically everything. So let's compare those two and have a look. So here we have the photos of those two devices. On the left side, the Xperia 10 Plus running with Selfish OS. On the right side, the Xperia 10 Plus running with Android. And yeah, let's compare some images and do some pixel peeping to see which photos are best or better and what are the differences. So first things first, you will see not much difference, so we have to go really in detail. From this image, on the first glance, what can you see? Yeah, this might be the Xperia 10 Plus running on Android, so Android version. It's a bit brighter. Here it's a bit darker. So maybe the white balance is a bit different, but it's not only the white balance that is different. Let's go here to this one, to this post. You can see there is a different white balance. This is much brighter than this here, which is a lot darker for some reason. You can also see it here on the SC. And when we go to the house here in the middle, you can see there's not only a white balance difference, but there's also a color difference. So we have a much brighter color here, a much punchier color here. Actually, I would say it's not only brighter in a sense, but it's also much punchier, this color here. And this is a difference. And when it comes to the real scene, how did the real scene look like? I have to admit here that the Xperia 10 Plus running Selfish OS did a better job when capturing this photo, because the colors here of this building are more realistic than on this, because this orange, no, this building does not look like this orange. It's more like this kind of more going into a pinkish kind of color. And when it comes to sharpness, we can see here there's not much difference. You can see here the signs and the cars, and here you can see maybe again a brightness difference. It's about a bit darkish red here. It's a bit more, yeah, a more light red here, but also I think a bit more punchy red here as well. And yeah, the same goes to the signs here. And yeah, okay, here's green, here's yellow, yellow light. What you can see also is here, I think, a difference in processing. Here you can see it, I think, more clear that it's not only a bit brighter, this image, but it's also doing some processing. So if you compare those two, it's this red. Can zoom in a little bit more.
This red here is not the correct red. It's like glowing almost, so it's a bit more punch in this red, which is not correct. This is a more correct way. And what you can also notice is it's not only making this glow effect and this punchy color effect here, but it's also doing some processing as the letters are a bit thinner than here. It has more depth here, it's a bit thicker, the letters, than here. And again, realistically speaking, this is the more realistic photos on the left, and on the right it's a more processed photo. So from the first get-go, we can see that processing is done on the Xperia 10 Plus Android version a lot more than on the Selfish OS version. Let's see how this will work out in different other photos here. Again, the Selfish OS version on the left, and on the right we have the Android version. Here you can see again a blown out picture, and this Android version made the image a little bit more bright in this case than the Selfish OS version. So again, the same kind of behavior. It tends to make images a little bit brighter than they should be, I would say, because in this case I think it doesn't do a good job, a justified job, because yeah, okay, here it's a bit dark, here you can, because of a lot more brightness, see perhaps a little bit more details, but in general there is not much difference. Also when it comes to noise levels are almost the same. But when it comes to noise, let's see, let's take a look at other pictures as well. For noise pictures, I have other pictures that I can show you. For example, this one here, which is also different behavior as well, but when it comes to noise, it's also one of the pictures where you can see a difference in terms of noise. So what we can see here now is on the left, on the Selfish OS version, we have a brighter image. On the right, we have a more dull image. And it's the same situation. There's nothing much changed here. So what we can see here is also a difference in depth of field. When you can see here, this is sharp. This is also sharp. What we can see here is also a brightness change. So here a lot darker, here a bit maybe overblown. And when we go to the top, you can see here that the Selfish OS version is much noisier than the Android version, but the Android version is much blurrier as well. So there's some algorithm going on that is smoothing out the noise here, but it also, I think, focused more here on this face instead of the rest of the image, or instead of having a more conform image. Let's take a look at the noise, and this is also very interesting. And you can see here the difference, almost the same. Here you can see the lights of the router that I also photographed last time, and you can see here, wow, there's almost no noise. And here you can see, wow, there's a lot of noise. So there's a difference going on, there's processing going on. This one is clearly also noise reducing stuff, and yeah, this is clear also in some other images. But let's go to the sleeve image, so I know what images I showed to you. And yeah, let's take a look at the leaf, nice and sharp. And here, yeah, not so sharp. You can see I hit this was the focus point here, but you can see also that there's a slight difference in the picture itself. So this big droplet here is gone now, because another droplet basically hit on the second photo. So I'm not sure if I'm comparing here X to apples or something like this, but it looks a lot sharper, that's clear. But it could be also because I'm not focusing again on this big droplet. And we can see more details here on the Android version than on the Selfish OS version. Also a slightly different white balance again, and also this image is a bit darker in this case. Let's go to the next image, where we can see another thing which is interesting. Also, changing colors again, we can see here a lot darker red color. Here we can see a lot brighter red color. Again, when it comes to white balance of the wall, again, I think the SelfJS version did a better job, but you can see there's a difference in sharpness going on. So what I think is going on here, especially if you go here, is sharpening after taking the picture. The Sony Android device is doing some, the Sony app, the camera app is doing some sharpening, because it looks like it is artificially sharpening up stuff a little bit. So it's not only the focus that is missed here, maybe on the SelfJS device, but also sharpening going on. And we can see here, especially on this corner, okay, this is a bit softer, but here you can see some little, like someone with a sharp pencil did some points on this edges, on the edges here. And yeah, this is, has something to do with the anti-noise reduction that Sony has in his camera, in his camera app. So we can maybe see this here as well. Let's take a look at the next image, the next photo. And here you can see, yeah, here you can see it clearly. Both are not very sharp, that's clear. But for some reason, the left, the SelfJS version, seems a bit sharper than the Android version. It has nothing to do with sharpness at all. It has just something to do with the noise reduction going on the Android version, which is far more aggressive in the Android camera app than in the SelfJS app. You can see it on the green stick here. You can see little dots here and there. And here you, it's smoothing out, basically. And the same with the background here, the white and so on. It's smooth here. And here you can see a little bit of noise creeping in still. SelfJS and the advanced camera app that I used for taking this shot have has the option also to use noise reduction. There's a cute built-in version of noise reduction, and it is turned on, of course, but it's not so aggressive, and it's not using the same algorithm as the Android version is using. So they have a special version of noise reduction. Again, let's take a look here. What does this noise reduction do? You lose a little bit of detail. As you can see here, it's the same picture, same time. The sun did not change, and the clouds did not really change. You can see a difference when it comes to this bird here. You can see there are clearly highlighted versions here, highlighted aspects of the bird. You can see it under the eye, you can see it here on the stomach, I think, on the front, and you can see it here. And here, no, you don't see it anymore, because it is this noise reduction kicking in and smoothing everything out. And yeah, you cannot see the accentures basically of the birds and where now the highlights are. So they are smoothed out a little bit. This is one example that you can see. So where this noise reduction is going a little bit bad in a way, or where you lose a bit of detail. But on the other hand, you can see the carpet here in the back. I think it is a carpet in the background. A lot more noise here going on, creeping in here. And here it's smooth. It looks a little bit better than on the Android device. Let's go further and take a look at some stuff where it goes wrong, the noise reduction as well again, and where we can see difference in noise reduction, and where I clearly have to say I prefer the SelfJS way, putting or leaving a little bit of noise in there to have more details in the shot. Here you can see shot of both of these signs here look almost the same. Also, when it comes to color balance and so on, not much difference. But when you zoom in, let's zoom in here on the top, you can see a difference. You can see that this is smooth. So this background is very, very smooth. And this has, yeah, noise. It's not color, really, really, this nasty color changing noise that you have or mostly have on the XA2, for example, but it is simply noise. What does it do? Yeah, this noise is, of course, not only there for ruin the image, but also for giving it more structure. And you can see it here on the top of this wood. You can see here it's very, very smoothed out, and you lose basically details because it's smudging everything and putting colors together, and you're losing detail of this wooden board. And here you can see a little bit of details that is gone in the processed image of the Android version. So you can see here the little stripes going on and so on, which is completely smoothed out, and you cannot even see it here. So there's a clear difference going on here. This is noise reduction is turned on here and is definitely kicking in very, very nasty and changing and removing stuff. And yeah, you have to take a look at what you prefer more. I prefer more, I have to say, the Savage S version, because you don't lose detail. Just like, for example, this black thing here, and this little dark spot here is here almost gone. It's not, you cannot see it anymore because it's smoothed out, and here it is kept. So the Savage S noise reduction is less aggressive and producing more detailed images, especially if you take a look at the 100% view. If you take a look at the normal view, you can see, or only take a look at the smartphone view, you will not notice any difference. But we are pixel peeping here right now, and taking a look at the details and detail level, and you clearly can see a little bit more detail on the Savage S version when it comes to this, because the noise reduction is not as strong as on the Android version. And yeah, that's it for noise reduction. I think what I can show you as well is another noise reduction where it makes sense, where it is even better than the Savage S version, because it depends. It's not always either or the other. Don't take a look at the white balance not right now. It's overblown here, but it was really a different kind of situation when it comes to lighting, I have to say. So the sun was coming out here, so it was overblown a bit here, because this picture I took one day later. So what you can see here is a big difference in noise reduction software. First of all, there's a bit of a different in view of field of view, but there's also in noise reduction, as you can see. First of all, it was a little bit brighter. This is the plus side on the Android version, because it was the day after this, after this picture here. And so this might have helped, but you can see more details clearly on the Android version here, with the stripes here going on here as well. It's nothing, because it smudges out because of all of the noise. And you can see also clearly, if I go to the right, what the noise reduction is doing. Let's go to the 100% view again. Here you can see what the noise reduction is doing and what the processing is doing. It's because it's not only noise reduction going on. Here you can see it's like someone punctured this and pushed out the noise a little bit, but also all those words here have some kind of over sharpening going on, some kind of sharpening effect going on. You can see it clearly if I go in a little bit more, that there are, it's like someone draw them again on top of them, and here not so much. So the Savage S version is much more natural in this case, and here there's sharpening going on. You can clearly see the sharpening filter going on and smoothing out with the noise reduction, and here it is a more natural way of doing this. But you can see here the Android version, I would say, clearly wins, because the picture overall looks a bit sharper and less noisy. Now let's come to the next image, where I clearly can say you will not notice any big difference between those two devices. And this is this image, where I can zoom in here. This was in focus, this was a focus point. You can see that both equally did not manage to get a really grab a good focus. And when it comes to the colors, I think it's the same. There's not much difference going on here. And here on the bottom, you can see clearly again the Sony effect on the Android camera app of sharpening and reducing noise. You can see it clearly here on this TV sign. Here you can see it's smudged out because of all the noise And here it is trying to reduce the noise, but it's creating this like little puncture effect. We can see the clearly because it's sharpening at the same time as it removes noise, and this is creating this not only working, not working as precisely as it should. So you can see little sharp punctures, which are basically or sharp points in this TV stripe here, which are basically the pixels, the noise pixels that got sharpened and that it didn't manage to filter out. So this is for that. You can see some sharpening going on also on the very clear on this pencil. You can see this is smooth and here it is over sharpened. You can see the it's much more dramatic looking and much more sharp, but it's artificially sharp, and this is not so much artificially sharp, I would say. Yeah, the rest of the image I think is not so interesting. Take a look here at this key. You can see here again the sharpening effect going on, and yeah, you can see here it's smooth but it's not so sharp, and here it's just like someone drew around this stuff and made it artificially sharper. But you can see here, of course, on the left side it's very, very unsharp, it's very, very soft, and here it is very, very sharp, even if it is a sharpening effect. So we have also another thing that we can see clearly, which is a sharpening effect. So noise again, I can show you noise again between those two devices. And versions, and here you can see not only noise but also again white color balance difference. Same time I took this photos, and you can see this is a lot brighter, again this is a lot darker when it comes to the scene directly. Let me zoom in. You can see, yeah, there is a lot more noise here in the 7.js version again, and here the denoising filter is going in and then trying to do its thing without compromising the sharpness, and the sharpness filter going on. You can see it clearly on the Centria logo here, and here we have it smooth basically, and here's somehow you can see also the noise going on, and this is with noise reduction it's trying to merge pixels and sharpen stuff, and here this is here we have noise clearly. The noise reduction is not as great, but it's not sharpening up stuff, so it's not sharpening up the noise, which is I think a plus for the CephJS version. But if you have it at 100% view, I would say yeah, this looks smoother, this looks a little bit more noise going on there. But when you take a look at the controls here, I would say even with the noise here in the 7.js picture, it's you can see more detail, like the sound virtualizer, you can read it here, it is a little bit soft, and the same goes for the buttons and the Panasonic logo. It's the, here you can Panasonic, you can really read it, and here it's like Pan and the rest you cannot read anymore because it's smoothened out, it's soft in a way. And yeah, this is what noise reduction does in this little areas and details, especially also on the volume buttons, your volume keys, you can see it. So again, a lot more noise on the 7.js version, but it's for the benefit, I would say, of the picture. So because you gain a little bit more in terms of sharpness. And now the last image, the last photo that I want to show you, is a photo of my keyboard. Yeah, granted I have to clean it up one day, but we can see it directly on the first glances that the 7.js version managed to take a sharp shot, so the autofocus worked pretty nice. And here it is a bit of soft on the Android version, I'm not sure why. You can see it just did not manage to find the right spot, the right focus, and you can see it here on the control key, on the STRG key, and if I go to the right on the numpad you can see it more clearly, It's just soft, ultra soft, and even all the sharpening filters that the Android version uses does not produce a sharp picture here. But you can see also a noise difference again here. Noise is creeping in a bit here. It is completely smooth, like baby smooth, I would say. These keys look like a little bit like very, very smoothed out. And here you can see a little bit of structure of the keys. And yeah, that's it, I think, for this comparison between those two devices. I hope you enjoyed this comparison. What do you think is better, the Android version, the Android software, what it does with trying to reduce noise and putting a sharpening filter on top because the noise reduction filter will create a bit of softness? Or do you like the more noise level in the Selfish S pictures, but then a little bit more details in the pictures? Yeah, would interest me. So just put a comment in the comment section, and that's everything for this little Selfish S podcast. I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching. Bye.